Hi friends, in this video, let's talk about dynamic parameter in the Power BI. So this is one of the important concept and the very recent concept in the Power BI. Here I will explain how to use the parameters in the Power BI dynamically. Before going to explain in the Power BI window, let me show you the data which I am planning to use in the Power BI visualizations. If you see the data, so I am planning to read the data from the SQL server, from the employee table, and around like 8 columns are there in my table with a name of employee ID, first name, last name, gender, SSN, salary, department number, and location. So these are all the 8 columns I have in my employee table. So let me load this employee table in the Power BI window. Then let me create one visualization. Lastly, I'll go to the parameter. Let me go to the Power BI. So this is an empty page which does not have anything. Let me connect to the data source. How to connect? Let's click on get data. Click on SQL server. Here you need to provide your server name. So here if your server name is dot, you can give the dot. If your server name is xyz.gmail.com, you can give that server name as well. If you see, my server name is .sql2012 and I am going with a import only, not a direct query. So in the previous video, we already talked about what is the difference between direct query and import query. Let's click on OK with the import. Once I click on OK with the import, in the next video, it shows the list of databases available in that particular server. Let's select the any of the database. My database name is C#. Under that, I have an employee table, EMP. So once you select that, in the right side, immediately right side, you can see some data. So once you're okay with this data, if you feel you are planning to take this data for our example, let's click on load. So once you click on load, it may take a while to load the data based on the size of the data. May take a while. Let's wait for a moment. Yes, it's loaded. It's loaded. If you see, this is my data set now. Now I can call employee as a data set. If you want to rename this, you can rename this. And let's design a simple visualization. So here, this is a visualization. Let me design it first. Okay, let me take salary and gender. And let me increase the font sizes of it so that in the later stages, I can easily see the labels and all. I can increase, I can keep the data labels on, and y-axis font I can keep it as little more, even more, and even x-axis font also let me keep it is little more. Where is that? Yeah, here it is 11 by default. Let me make it as some 13 14 15. Here M and F, so here I am going with a M and F. And let me make the data label size also a little bigger so that for me understanding will be more better. Let me increase that as well. Where is that? Yeah, text size is 9 9. Let me increase to, yeah, see, this is the visualization of the employee data set with a column of gender and a salary. So let me make it this to center title. Let me go here, title is on, and let me move it to the center so that will be easy. And let me increase the size of it. So this till here, it is a very general visualization. Now let me create a parameter. It is very simple. It is important how to create it. So once you are okay with this, let's click on edit queries. Click on edit queries. So if you click on edit queries, you will get the data set in the left side. So with the name of how many data sets you have, you will get that many data sets in the left side. My data set name is employee. I got here. Now I want to create a parameter on the top of the country, on the top of the location, actually on the top of the location. If you're planning to do that, select this and right click and click on a and add as a new query. So once you click on add as a new query, it will show you the list of countries which are available in your EMP data set. But ideally, if you see, the unique values are 3 or 4, but if you see all the duplicate values, how to remove the duplicate values. So select this, right click, and you can remove the duplicates. You have a remove duplicate option. Let's click on it. So once you do that, you will get the default distinct values. So this is how we remove the duplicates. Till here, like we just remove the duplicates. Now right click here. Now yeah, the duplicates are removed till here. Once the duplicates are removed, then let's come to the add column window, home window. Once the duplicates are removed, then go for the parameter creation. Till now, so we just created EMP data set and we created one visualization, column chart visualization, and then we created a list with a based on the query which are of having distinct country names, distinct locations. Now let me go to the parameters. Let's click on manage parameters. Click on manage parameters. If you have any parameters, you can see here. As of now, I don't have any parameters. This is the first parameter I am planning to create. If that is the scenario, let's click on new. Click on new for the new parameter. So here you can give the name of the parameter, select country or select location. My terminology here, it is location. I'm giving as a select location. So if you want to give a description here as, please select location. I can use the full spelling location, and type any is fine, and suggested value. So I am planning to take the suggested value from the query, So what is your query name? So here my query name is LOC. If you see the name of the query here, if you see the name of the query here is location, you can see here. Okay. So now let's select that query and the current value. You need to give compulsory one value. So that value I am keeping as a UK location. If you see here, I just clicked on new. I gave the name, and I gave the description, and the type I gave as any, and suggested values. Here I have any values, list of values, and query. If you want to go for list of values, you need to create here, but I have query ready with me. Let's set the query, and the query name is location, and the first value I'm giving as a UK. Let's click on OK. So once you select that, so here you created a list with the name of location, and you created parameter with the name of the select location, and default value is UK. So if you see the icon changes, for parameter you have this icon, for list you have this icon, for data set you have this icon. You can see the difference in the icons. If you see the difference in the icons, these are the highlights. I just highlighted to see the difference in the icons. Okay, so now, so once you are done creating the parameter, then go back to the employee data set and link that parameter with a data set. Then how to link that? Go to the LOC column, select this, click on text filters. Here you have a equals, click on equals. So once you click on equals, you will get a window. You will get a window here. You need to select the parameter. You have to click on ABC. Let's click on ABC. Here you need to click on your parameter, means generic name. You need to click parameter. Once you select the parameter, it will show you the list of parameters which are available in this window. So I have only one parameter with the name of select location. Still you can see that parameter name. You can see the parameter name here. So this is the parameter you have. If you have multiple parameters, it will come like here. Okay. So once you're done with the selection, so let's click on OK. So here, once you select the UK parameter, by default, the data set will be filtered for all the UKs. Okay. So now, if you want to change the parameter value UK to some USA, you can do that. So now USA, here it automatically reflects, done okay. Now let's go back to the EMP data set. It automatically reflected and you can see the USA data here, you can see that. So once you are okay with this edit query window, query editor window, nothing to do here. So we just created a list and we just created a parameter and we linked that parameter to the EMP data set. That's it. So once you are done with this window, let's click on close and apply. Here you have in the left top side, you have a close and apply. You can see this. So let's click on this close and apply. So once you click on close and apply, it automatically saves in the Power BI pages. Let's do that. Close and apply. Apply and also close, you can do that. See, that changes has to reflect in your Power BI page. It may take a while. Yeah, do you see the difference here? Because earlier you have some big number, now you have some smaller number. You can see the difference. So it means that parameters has been applied. Now how to save this? How to provide a facility for the user to select this? You need to save this page with a template. Power BI template. How to do that? You can simply, this Power BI page is not saved yet. You can simply click on save. So here I can change it to a template, and I can keep it as a parameter with the name of parameters dot. I can keep it as a parameters. Let our parameters one. There is a different name. Okay, click on save. Means this, I can give a template description for parameters. Once you click on OK, save. Okay, so this is how you need to handle the parameters in the Power BI visualizations. So now in the next time, if you go to that particular window, it will ask you what country you want. So you can select the different country and you can see the data respective to that country. So this is how we handle the dynamic parameters in the Power BI window. That's it. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments section. I'll try to answer as my best. Thank you. That's it.